John Tweddle, who runs the Angela Marmont Centre. I'm Beth Stone, who is undertaking a lot of activities to prepare. What we do here to engage people in biodiversity on their doorstep.
So we're celebrating our 10th anniversary last week. We've engaged over 150,000 people since then in science of studying the UK's nature.
The water, the general, of course, yes,
so you'll get an idea of the scale. And that's actually one of our orchids, which is quite useful in life, but loses most of its colour when it's dry.
Is there anywhere keeping record of colour? Is it
flammatory? One of the ways that... Yeah, I can show you that, shouldn't I? So one of the ways that we're developing approaches to developing the museum and the partners, which you came from.
So we're just experimenting.
There need to be specific parts of DNA, different barcodes, I call it. But this is looking at some DNA that was captured as part of a public event, a BioBlitz. And it's all in there, and it's a tiny little drop of the solution goes onto that bit there. Yeah. And that is sequencing. Each green bit is a piece of DNA going through that. So that's about an hour and a half, that will sequence 655,000 strands of DNA. So within an hour or so, you get a good idea of all of the life.
And where does the UK sit in globally in terms of the research and, I suppose, the public interaction with biodiversity and things like that?
So as well as biodiversity loss, we're trying to tackle some wider society challenges. We know from research, for example, that disconnection from nature is a really big issue across society. So one of these things is so that's a little midge larvae.
Who are they?
Ghost midge. This year, it's still got its external gills, actually, it hasn't quite transformed.
So how many are in the UK? They're different species?
Different species, yeah. We have three species in the UK, and two are very common. This is actually a common newt, a smooth newt.
Absolutely. Lovely to see you again. And we're going to see you. Bye.